Hey there! I've got another unscheduled movie review for you today because I want to take a few minutes to tell you about The Vast of Night, a 2019 film that premiered on Amazon Prime this past weekend. Directed by Andrew Patterson, it is a 1950s set science fiction film that stars Sierra McCormick and Jake Horowitz. The opening scene of this movie zooms in on an old television set as you hear the voice of Rod Serling. Except it isn't him, it's a close imitation of his voice, introducing an episode of not The Twilight Zone, but Paradox Theater, and it's an episode titled The Vast of Night. The Vast of Night is set in fictional Cayuga, New Mexico. One night in the 1950s, a switchboard operator listening to her friend's radio show notices an odd frequency cutting in. The phone rings, and she hears the same sound on the other end. After some more strange calls that get cut off, she contacts her friend at the radio, and they set about trying to identify the mysterious frequency. What they uncover is something much bigger than they could have imagined. My brother heard about this movie a couple weeks ago and thought it might be something we could all watch together, so Sunday night we checked it out. Beforehand, I did take a quick glance at the IMDb page, and I set my expectations very low. It looked like a super low-budget production, a period piece focusing on teens, played by a cast of unknowns. It had the potential to be really bad, so I braced myself for disappointment. But, as you might be able to guess, considering I've decided to take the time and effort to make a video about it, The Vast of Night was not a disappointment, not at all. I really liked it. If this was in fact such a low-budget production, they did a great job making the most of what little they had. They kept it low-key and simple, with a small cast, a contained setting. It takes place in one night. It might even occur in real time. If it's not exact, it's pretty darn close. The first chunk of the movie sets up the location, the period, the atmosphere, and especially the two main characters, Faye and Everett. These two have to carry pretty much the whole movie, and I thought they were great. He's the local tech whiz called in every time something goes haywire, and a local radio DJ. She covers the town's switchboard for her mom and is an aspiring radio host herself. The opening sequence has a fast-paced but easy-going rhythm to it. I know that sounds oxymoronic, but that's what it is. Far from sounding corny and artificial, like, okay, you got a list of 50 slang and now you've crammed everything into your script, I was surprised how naturally the dialogue flowed. And it was funny! There's a long sequence in which the two main characters walk to the switchboard office, and we follow them down this dark, isolated road. Their conversation is engaging and further establishes their characters, but more than that, the scene continues to establish the mood. It's eerie, and you get this prolonged sense of anticipation. You're not sure if you should be looking for something lurking in the shadows, if something's going to jump out. I enjoyed this method of building tension. I don't think that it would appeal to everyone, but for this film and for this viewer, it worked, and it was much better than defaulting to jump scares. Later, there was another even longer tracking shot that really impressed me. It starts with Faye standing in the doorway of the switchboard station, goes through the town and people's yards, to the school, through the basketball game in progress, back outside and through more yards across town, to Everett standing outside the radio station. If I were a cynical reviewer, I'd complain that it doesn't serve a purpose in moving the plot forward, therefore it is just padding, which they desperately needed because they did not have enough story to make up a feature-length film. That is probably what some critics have said, I don't know, but I think it did serve a purpose. It served two purposes for me. It made me nervous, and it was fun to watch. But the movie made the wise decision, I think, not to show too much. What you do see is kept to a minimum, and you have to wait for it, and it's relatively simple. The special effects are quite elegantly done. I've come away from many sci-fi or alien movies, especially ones made in the last 10 years or so, feeling like the last act ruined the rest of the movie. They take things too far, don't know when to quit. They spoil the mystery and atmosphere of the thing by showing too much, or showing something that doesn't age well, or just isn't satisfying. I feel that didn't happen here. The ending is, well, I'm not going to tell you how it ends, but it's just inconclusive enough to make you wonder, but not so abrupt and unfinished that it makes you mad. At no point was I bored, but you should know that if you're looking for an explosive alien invasion action movie, this isn't it. And it does make some bold moves. There are a couple segments where one character is just sitting, listening to another character tell a story. The focus is on what you hear, not on what you see. And at one point, the movie even fades to black. There is literally nothing to look at. There is one scene where I think it loses some momentum. A woman is being interviewed, and while what she's saying is spooky, the scene's lack of movement saps away some of the energy you came into it with. It was a risky choice to hold on this scene for so long, so close to the climax, and I think the movie suffers for it slightly. But not that much. The Vast of Night just came out, or at least just came out on Amazon Prime, so I don't know what people think of it. I hope I'm not embarrassing myself by praising it, but it doesn't matter. I really liked it. As for the people who watched it with me, it wasn't exactly my dad's cup of tea, he's not so into science fiction, but my brother and my mom liked it, and when it was over, we sat around for a while and swapped our UFO stories. So that was fun! Those are my thoughts on The Vast of Night. I hope you enjoyed the review and that you'll check out the movie if it sounds interesting to you. And once you've seen it, feel free to come back and leave your thoughts on the movie in the comments below. I look forward to reading them, and What Else I Saw in May Part 1 is coming up next, so I hope you'll stay tuned for that. Thanks for watching!